I rise today to introduce articles of impeachment against Associate Justices of the Supreme Court, Clarence Thomas and Samuel Anthony Alito Jr. Mr. Speaker, I am here today presenting these articles of impeachment not because I am a Democrat and not because I am blind to its odds in a Republican-led chamber. I present them because it is the right thing to do. And while our framers perhaps may not have envisioned someone like me in this seat, they absolutely did envision the necessity and value of the impeachment action upon which I seek to advance today.
That is Representative Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez speaking in an incredibly sober and I think measured way about the untenable situation that we've gotten into in terms of the Supreme Court. We have some wildly biased and corrupt justices, and she is now seeking to impeach two of them, two of the worst, Clarence Thomas and Samuel Alito Jr., accusing them of these crimes.
Against Justice Thomas, the resolution includes three total articles. One count of failure to disclose financial income, gifts, reimbursements, property interest liabilities, and transactions, among other information. And two counts of refusal to recuse from matters concerning his spouse's legal and financial interests before the court. The second resolution includes the following impeachment articles against Justice Alito. One count of refusal to recuse from cases in which he had a personal bias or prejudice concerning a party before the court, and one count of failure to disclose financial incomes, gifts, reimbursements, property interests, among other information.
Yeah, so she's listing a whole lot of things that they did. You have the bias on the one hand, the obvious entanglements that they and their family have in some of the cases that they have ruled on, not just ruled on, but participated in the majority to just flout any constitutional standards, any of the precedent that we've gone into this election cycle with. And then you have the corruption as well. It's legion, just years and years and years of accepting millions of dollars of gifts. They clearly believe that the law should no more apply to them than it does to Donald Trump. And we'll get to more of why AOC thinks it's so important that we make the step of impeaching these justices, but I want to turn to you, JR, and find out what you think about this.
Just from the first thoughts off the bat, we are considering, of course, Democrats are afraid and worried and all this stuff, considering what the response may be, maybe from her fellow Congress people over this impeachment of the Supreme Court justices, putting it forward and also pointing out that she knows this probably isn't something that's going to go very far because of their fealty to this same process and these same people, the same corruption that we've been watching since forever. But it doesn't mean we shouldn't do it. Just because James Comer and Jim Jordan like to come up with sham investigations to come after people and then admit later that it was all BS doesn't mean that you can't do real things like this impeachment.
Yeah.
Just because they got mad about previous impeachments that were very valid on the former president, who keeps showing us why they were very valid to this day, doesn't mean you shouldn't do it again. Just because they're going to complain doesn't mean you shouldn't do it again. They're going to complain no matter what. So yeah. I'm glad that she's doing it. I'm glad she's going forward with it, because if nothing else, people will pay attention to what it is that you're saying about it, even if it doesn't go to the point of getting actual impeachment proceedings completed and voting them out and everything like that, the confirmation of it. Information comes, and then people eventually go, you know what? Why the hell do we allow Supreme Court justices to take gifts and money and loans and school tuitions and flights and lodging and food and drinks and hanging out with these uber rich people that are directly connected to some of these cases? Let them ask the question, because if we keep acting like it's not happening, they'll be able to listen to the people who are screaming at them all the time to tell them they shouldn't care about it. The normalcy has to change. If they're normalizing corruption, it's time to call out corruption every time. They'll get mad at you, but it doesn't mean you shouldn't keep doing it.
Yeah. Yeah, 100%. And she says it has basically no chance of succeeding. And we all know why it has no chance of succeeding. And this should bother any conservatives watching this more than anyone else. It's because the Supreme Court is corrupt. There are no ethical guidelines. There's basically no legal guidelines to how much money they can take from the wealthiest people in the country, who are then going to have business before the court. And then they will be paid back for the gifts they provided to these incredibly greedy elites. And the issue is that the Republicans in the House and the Senate mostly don't want to do anything about that, because they want to have as much access to this corrupt money as the justices do. They love the fact that they can all gorge themselves on elite money and then pay them back, but pay them back with a currency they don't care about. policy. It doesn't matter to them. They've made the money. They've got the cushy jobs lined up as lobbyists. They're getting the campaign donations. They're getting the trips. They're getting the presents and all that. And it happens in both the House and the Senate, as well as the Supreme Court. So why they're fine with it, and which is why later on in the show, when we talk about the stock trading ban, many of these Republicans are going to vote against it, and some Democrats too, because they are incredibly corrupt individuals. And as you said, look, the term impeachment gets thrown around all the time now because Marjorie Greene and Ana Paulina Luna don't know any other words. But they'll come up and be like, we should impeach Mayorkas because the war at the border, invasion, dereliction of duty. Or like, okay, you can say whatever you want. But when you have AOC come out and say, here are the cases that they 100% should have recused themselves from. If they did not recuse themselves from these cases, then under what circumstances would they ever, let alone the obvious violations of tax law? We're not just talking about violations of ethical obligations. We're talking about legal obligations to report the income that they've received on these massive gifts. Thanks for watching our video. Did you know that you can support our show by becoming a subscriber? Just click the subscribe button and also ring the bell so that you get notifications when we're live or when we post new content.